Hello and welcome to Middleware Friday for January 26th, 2018. So this is a special episode. This is episode number 50, which is actually hard to believe based upon how this whole idea was conceived. So this idea originated back at the MVP Summit in, I guess it was around November 2016. And so we were all of the MVPs were in a room, and the pro integration team was presenting to us, and we were talking about like things that we need to do in the community. And Jim Herrer, who's the group program manager for pro integration, he had challenged us and was encouraging us to us MVPs to start delivering some video content. So I had a chat with Saravana Kumar, who's obviously from BizTalk 360. And we thought this would be a good idea. I was kind of thinking of maybe going the YouTube route, but I think it made sense to partner up with BizTalk 360 and leverage some of the support and reach that that organization can provide as well. So that's what got this kicked off. And I think certainly inspired by some of the people that I follow that are creating a lot of content these days in video form. So people like Gary Vaynerchuk, and Casey Neistat, CT Turner as well. So I think those are people that I watch on YouTube, and I find it pretty interesting how they are using video as a storytelling mechanism. And certainly that's my goal with this channel. Obviously, I've got some work to do in terms of catching up with those folks. But that was some of the motivation for actually going ahead and building out this channel. Now, I have to thank some of the people at BizTalk 360, including Sriham, Ravana, and Gowri for helping out in spreading the word around Middleware Friday and ensuring that the people are aware that it does exist and that it's hosted and performs well. So thank you to you folks for helping out. Also want to thank Steph Jan Wiggers, who joined me on this journey. I think it's probably the end of September, early October. In part, I took on a role at Microsoft in the Microsoft Flow team, and I knew it would be very difficult to do this every week. So certainly appreciate the horsepower that Steph Jan is providing. But in addition, since I've joined Flow, and even a little bit before, if you actually go through and look at the episode history, I've been talking a lot about Flow, which makes a lot of sense. That's where I spend most of my time these days. So naturally, I'm going to talk about that, and I also want to use this as an opportunity for more people to find out about Flow. But knowing that I come from the pro integration space and historically have done a lot of BizTalk and Logic apps, I think it's pretty important for this audience to continue to get that sort of content. So I like the fact that Steph Jan can focus on things like transforming JSON in Logic apps with the new Liquid capabilities and integrating Azure Search and Cosmos DB, because I think it provides a lot of variety for the show. So that's great, and I'm happy to have him on board. And we'll try to collaborate as much as we can. I think that's a lot of fun when we get together and start talking shop. I know MVP Summit is coming up here early March, so he'll be in Seattle. So looking forward to doing an episode or two with him while he's abroad. Now, what does the next 50 episodes look like? Well, that's hard to say. I think we're, continuing full steam ahead. I think there's plans to continue on and keep doing this. And I think as long as people watch and are interested in the content, we'll keep creating it. I know it was very humbling and rewarding to meet so many people at Integrate USA that had nice things to say about integration or about Middleware Friday and how they were always looking forward for episodes, and they were learning a lot. I know even when I joined Microsoft, I received an email from someone who had, basically said, yeah, they're happy to see me join Microsoft, and they followed me on Middleware Friday all the time, so that was certainly nice to see. One thing I will say for myself is, I hope that people are learning from these videos, but certainly I'm learning a bunch from these videos as well. So this gives me an opportunity to go explore, and then certainly I'm happy to share my learnings with you, and I think it becomes a win-win. So if I look back at some of the episodes that I really enjoyed, certainly early on, the first episode, which was January 6th, was API management and Logic apps. At the time, that feature, that integration was just in preview and was brand new, and it was exciting to talk about. Also, let's see if we can go ahead and find it. I thought this work around Power Apps and cognitive services was super interesting. I'd done a little bit around Power Apps in the past, but bringing these two technologies together was very, very cool. And then I think another one that sticks out for me is ServiceNow integration with Microsoft Flow Buttons. And this is where I was using the BTTN service. So these are, you know, three of the shows that I really enjoyed. I learned a lot from each one of them, and I think that's what's part of making this fun. So we will have a survey shortly, and we'll collect some more feedback and try to get a gauge on what are some of the topics you'd like us to focus on, and we'll continue to go ahead and do that. In the meantime, for this episode, we're going to talk a little bit about Flow Mobile. And, you know, I just ran into this use case, and I think it's killer. I think it's, you know, extremely easy to build. And, you know, to do this, like, by coding it yourself, you'd be, it'd take you a lot of time, but using Flow, it's such a breeze. So we're going to go ahead and roll with that content for this week. So Steph Jan will be around next week, but thanks for tuning in. You know, thanks for continuing to support the show. It's a pleasure to be part of this community, the Microsoft integration community is second to none. So we'll keep going and we'll see where this goes, but we're certainly not stopping anytime soon. So thanks a lot. In this case, consider there's a property management organization, and this could be any sort of property management. It could be hotels, it could be long-term rentals, it could be just regular apartment complexes. And really, it could be used in any scenario where you have some level of inspection that has to take place. So in this case, we've got a property management organization. We have maintenance people or cleaners that are regularly in the building as customers are moving in, moving out, etc. And what they want to be able to do is record whenever a piece of furniture or other object needs to be replaced. Now, like any other cost-conscious organization, this organization doesn't want to waste money by making repairs or replacements on things that don't really need to be replaced. Now, in this case, we've got a supervisor who wants the ability to approve any new expenditures when a piece of furniture or equipment needs to be replaced. So in this case, we've got, let's call him Joe, who works for the property management organization. And as part of his rounds, he discovers that there's a door, and in this case, it's damaged and it needs to be repaired. So in this case, he doesn't require the approval of his supervisor. So what he can actually do is pull out his mobile device and use his Microsoft Flow application. He's able to provide some details about the door, the unit, the location, and his recommendation for whether it needs to be repaired or replaced, and an estimated cost. And once he's done populating that information, he'll click a button, and that information will get sent to a Microsoft Flow. Now, within this flow, there's a few different steps that we want to take place. The first is we're going to take the image that was inputted and we're going to save it to SharePoint Online, and we're going to put it into a document library. Now, we're going to do this for a couple reasons. Number one, we want to ensure that the manager has the ability to actually view the picture and which will help them decide whether or not the article needs to be replaced or repaired. Later on down the road, we also have this catalog of items that have been replaced and repaired, and a status for approvals where we can also track that. So we could also run analytics down the road and actually see if a specific employee tends to repair more than replace, but that's outside of the scope of this particular talk. Once we've deposited the image into SharePoint Online, we're going to get a URL for that specific image, and we can then construct an approval. And we will include that link to the picture as well as the other supplementary information and send that off to the manager. The manager will then have the ability to look at all of the information and quickly decide whether or not they want to spend the money to either repair or replace that piece of furniture or equipment. Now, in the event that the manager does want to approve the work, Flow will then go ahead and create a case inside of Dynamics 365 and the service module, where we have a record of the work that needs to be done and some additional costs or some estimated costs, and also a link to the image of the piece of equipment that needs some attention. In the event that the manager doesn't want to spend the money, they'll have the ability to reject the approval. And in this case, an email will be sent back to the requester. So in this case, it was our maintenance worker, where they will get a justification or rationale for the manager's decision. And they can then go upon their business and focus on other activities that do require their attention. So let's go ahead and build out our demo. So let's now navigate to the Flow Maker portal, which can be found at flow.microsoft.com. Now, once I'm in microsoft.com, I'm going to see a lot of different options here, some learning materials, templates, the ability to find connectors, things of that nature. But I'm going to focus on my flows, which is going to provide a list of all of the flows that I'm the sole author of. If there was flows that I've shared or that have been shared with me, I could access them from the team flows. So I've gone ahead and prepared this flow, but we'll walk through it in great detail so that you can replicate it if you wish. Now I'm going to click on Edit Flow. And what we're going to see is that the trigger that we've chosen to use is manually trigger a flow. And this is really the Flow Mobile button trigger. Now there's some data that we want to collect as part of this when we kick off this flow. The first one being location. And location is going to be a list of options. So if I was to add this, another list, I could click on add an input. I could choose text. I could then indicate that this is going to be a list of options. And I can type, say, Banff or Seattle. And then when the mobile app is launched and the user needs to provide input, they could actually select one of these items as opposed to going ahead and typing it in, which wouldn't be a great experience on a mobile device. The next field we want to focus on is the unit number. So for example, if we're going to choose the Banff Springs Hotel as the property where there's some work required, we're going to need a unit number. And in this case, it's just going to be text. The next input that we need is the actual image. So in this case, we want a picture of the piece of furniture that needs to be repaired or placed. And to add an image, we can actually go ahead and add a new input. In this case, we want to choose a file. So that's how we're going to accomplish that. Now we also want to get a recommendation from our maintenance personnel where they can go ahead and choose repair or replace. And lastly, we want them to provide an estimated cost, which will help the approver decide whether or not they want to go ahead with this particular action. So that's the flow button. Now, the next thing we want to be able to do is to create a file inside of SharePoint. So just to give you an example of how this looks, we can go ahead and add an action, and then we can choose SharePoint. And then we can go ahead and we're going to see create file. Now, in order to create a file, we need to provide a site address. So basically, this is the SharePoint Online URI, the folder, and then we need to be able to provide a name of the file plus the content of the file. I'm just going to delete this because I'll show you the action that's been completed. So in this case, this is the location of my SharePoint site. Here's the subfolder for it. And let's just go take a quick look at this site. Here's our document library where we're going to store the files. And then note, we've also created a few different custom columns where we can add additional attributes. We do need to provide a file name. Now in this case, we aren't able to grab the file name off of the image that was uploaded, But for this case, we just want to provide a unique name. So what we can go ahead and do there is use an expression, which is like an out-of-the-box function provided by Flow. And in this case, it's just going to give us a UTC now time, and we're going to append a .jpg so that we can open up the image within a web browser. And then what we're going to do is we want to get the content that was provided from the Flow mobile app. And in this case, we had called it item requiring attention. And we can tell that this is the item because it also has the comment that was there around the comment that was included in the text box, which says, please select file or image. So all we need to do is to click on that and it'll show up in our create file action. It's going to go ahead and upload the image to the SharePoint online directory. But next we want to be able to add additional attributes. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the update file properties action. Once again, we'll provide the same site address, the same library name, and then we need to provide the item that we want to go ahead and update. So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to use the item ID that was provided in the response from our create file action. And you can see that here and in the action above. So that's going to link the attributes that we're now going to provide with the image that was previously provided. So as part of this, we want to include the property name, which is going to come from the Flow mobile action that we previously dropped onto our canvas. And in this case, it's a field called location. Similarly, we want to be able to drag the unit number over as well. And we can provide that here. And lastly, we want to be able to pull over the username. And this is going to be the user that is logged in to the Flow mobile app. So that's going to be automatically captured. And we want to record that within our SharePoint document library as well. So at this point, we've received the request from the Flow mobile application. We've created the image file inside of SharePoint and we've updated it to include additional properties. Next, we want to now create an approval. And approval is very simple to add. We can go ahead and add an action and then just type in approval. And then we'll see that the approvals action does show up and we can simply just add that to our canvas. Now we do have two options. We, when creating an approval, we can have an approval type that requires anyone from the assigned list to approve or deny the request, or it can be everyone from the assigned list. So you can think of it as one or all. So those are the two scenarios that are currently supported in our Flow approvals. Now, in the example that I've configured, I'm going to say anyone from this list. Now, in this case, I only have one person, which is really me, but that's okay. It could be others if we wanted to. And I'm going to provide a title and it's going to say new work order. And once again, I can use the outputs from my previous triggers and actions to provide a more meaningful request. So in this case, I'm going to say there's a new work order for unit number dash location. And those are elements that are being captured in the Flow mobile application. Now, in addition, I'm going to provide an assigned to, which is my email address, as I mentioned, and then some more details. So I'm going to include the recommended action. So if the maintenance personnel recommends a replacement or repair, that'll be captured. And then also the estimated cost. Finally, we'll include a link to the item, which is a link to the image that was uploaded to the SharePoint site. And we'll actually find this as an output to the update file properties action, which is right above. Well, if we scroll down, we'll find link to item. So that's going to give us the full path to the image, and that will allow the approver to open up that link and see the piece of furniture or equipment that needs to be replaced. Now, we want to include a condition here. because we really have two actions that can take place. If the approver decides to approve it, we're going to proceed to create that case inside of Dynamics 365. However, if they decide to deny it, then we want to take a different action. So that's what we're going to go ahead and do here. We will check to see the response, and this is going to be a response from the approval itself. And if it is set to approve, then we were going to go down the positive path. And in this case, we're going to go ahead and we're going to try to find the account for this specific property. Now, there's obviously many different ways where you can configure Dynamics 365. But for the purpose of this exercise, we chose that every property is essentially an account. And we're able to filter out accounts because we really need to find the account at this point. And we can go ahead and do that by using the list records action and then filter on the name. So now in order to connect to Dynamics 365, it is actually quite simple. We can go ahead and insert a new step and then add an action. And we'll go ahead and search for Dynamics 365. Now there are a few options here. We've got Dynamics 365. We also have Dynamics 365 for financials and then Dynamics 365 for operations. So in this case, we really want Dynamics 365 and we're going to use list records. Now as part of this, we will get prompted for a login where we need to provide our credentials. In this case, I am using a test tenant where I have my own credentials. Now, once I've authenticated, I need to provide the organization name. So in this case, there's customer engagement home, and then focus on the name of the entity that I want to list records for. So in this case, we want to choose accounts. Now the problem with this right now is that it's going to return all account records. And I don't want to have to loop through each one to try to find the location or the property. So if I'm passing in Banff Springs, I don't want to have to loop through each one to check on it. So instead, I can go ahead and use that OData query. And as you can see below here, we need to provide the name of the field, which in this case is called name, and then EQ, which is equals, and then single quotations, and then our location, which is once again found from a previous step, which in this case was the trigger, where we will be able to go ahead and find it. So I'm just going to go ahead and clean this up. So what will happen is, because this is list records, it has the potential to return an array of records. Now, in this particular case, I know that our account names are unique. So even though this is in a loop, I do know it's only going to execute once. But what I do want to do is I want to go ahead and create a case. And I'm going to create a case inside of the same instance of Dynamics 365. So in order to add this step, it would be the same way. I'm going to go ahead and do a search for Dynamics 365. I want to go ahead and create a new record once again. I want to go ahead and create a new record. I'm going to choose my engagement. And in this case, I'm going to select my entity of cases. So I'll just go ahead and clean that up. And when I go ahead and create a new record, there are some attributes I do need to provide. So one is a title. So I'm going to, as part of the title, include the location of the property plus the unit. I need to provide the account number, which came from our previous step when we went to go ahead and list records. I need to provide the customer type, which in this case is accounts. And then I want to provide a meaningful description, which includes the recommended action, the estimated cost, and then a link to the picture inside of SharePoint. So that's going to allow us to create a case. Now I want to provide an email back to the maintenance person who had initially launched the request, and I can go ahead and pull their email from the user email field, which comes from the Flow Mobile, and then I'll provide a subject of the unit for this location, has a work order which has been approved. We will include in it the case number, which was created in our previous step as part of the output from our create new record action. And we can also take the comments from the approver. So back up here, when we had the approver go ahead and approve this request, they're going to provide feedback, or they have the ability to provide feedback. We can include those comments as well. And you'll see that when we actually go ahead and run the demo. Lastly, we can go ahead and set the approval status inside of SharePoint. So if we head back here to the SharePoint library, we can actually see that when the image is created, the approved attribute is set to no. And really the point of this is we want to be able to take a look at these later using analytics to figure out what are some of the different types of work orders that have had their requests approved versus denied. So that's that step. The set approval status is really the ability to update an item in SharePoint, and then we're going to change the approved attribute to yes. Now on the flip side, if we see that the approval was denied, we also want to inform the maintenance worker that this request has been denied so they can go about their day. So similarly, we have the ability to reach out to them using their email address. We can use a subject of unit location and that work order denied. And then we'll also include the comments that were provided by the approver so that they have a better understanding of why this particular request was not approved. So now I'm going to flip over and we will go ahead and run this demo and see this in action. Before we get into the demo, I did want to show you Dynamics 365 because we haven't been there yet. I'm currently in the service module, and then I can select cases. So as you can see here, there's no cases that are currently active, but soon we'll go ahead and create one. Now, in order to run this demo, because I do want to show you the mobile capabilities, I'm going to go ahead and use a technology called Air Server, which is really going to emulate my iOS device. So I am running this on Apple, but certainly I could be running this on Windows Phone 10 or Android as well. Now I'm going to go ahead and click on the Flow button. And next I'm going to go ahead and click on Buttons. And these are all of the buttons that either I've created or that have been shared with me. And as you can see, there's a lot of buttons that you can create using any of those connectors inside of Microsoft Flow on the back end. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Case Management Property Inspection. And here, this is the interface that we would have designed earlier in the Flow Maker portal. Now, I have the ability to choose which location, and this is that list that I was talking about before. So instead of typing in all of these options and getting something wrong, I can go ahead and select Banff Springs, which I know will land correctly inside of Dynamics. Next, I need to provide a unit number, which in this case will be 1234. The next piece of information I need to provide is an image. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is upload a file. Can be from my camera or a photo library. In this case, it's a door that has been very much demolished. I'm going to then, as a recommendation, suggest that we replace this door, and I'm going to provide an estimated cost. So in this case, we'll say it's $700. I'll hit return, and then what I'm going to go ahead and do is click on Done in the top right-hand side of the screen, and my flow will now be executed. I'm going to stay in the mobile experience for this reason here. Now, I just received an approval request. Now, in this case, we are mixing persona here where I'm the maintenance person that's going ahead and creating the request. I'm also getting the approver. I'm also the approver. But you can imagine an approver sitting on a different mobile device who who is getting this request. And what they can see is they can see that a work order is being suggested for the Banff Springs property, unit 1234. We also have a link here, which we can go ahead and click to see the shape of the item that needs replacing. So after jumping through MFA and all of those great security features, I can now see the image on my phone. So what I can now do is I can go back to the request itself, and I'm going to say I want to approve this work order to proceed, and now I have the ability to provide options. So I'm going to say please proceed and then hit confirm. And there we can see my request has been approved. And if we head back over into Dynamics 365, we should see that a case has now been created. So sure enough, a case has been created. We can go ahead and open it up. And sure enough, we can see that it was for unit 1234. There's an estimated cost of $700. And here's the image of the door that does need some replacement. So let's head back over to SharePoint. We'll go ahead and refresh this. You can see about a minute ago there was an image uploaded. We can see the approval has been set to yes because we've captured the feedback from when I approved it. Once again, we can go ahead and click on this image and we'll see it show up here inside of SharePoint. Lastly, we'll go back to Flow. We're going to close this without saving. And we can see that it was successful. And we can actually go through each step and see the data that was captured, how long it took, and any output information as well. So for example, we can click on manually trigger a flow, and we can go ahead and see what were the inputs. We can download the outputs. Similarly with SharePoint, we can see what the inputs were and the outputs. So we have all of that visibility that we need in order to verify that our process is working successfully. I'm on the call, see you on TV, sunset don't change. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. Now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money.